everybody joining, everybody that's here that's able to be a part of this celebration. What one of the traditional things that we do whenever we come together in a circle like this, we ask for permission from our elders if it is okay that we proceed.
It's okay. With my blessing.
Thank you so much. And so with that said, we always honor our elders. We always put our elders first. And we always make sure that the children are taken care of as well. I'm Kemetic. And in our culture, there was Kemet, and then there was you have the land of Cush. So those are the first lands, you know, places where people, a lot of art and a lot of history was developed. People don't realize this, that even here in America, this is called Turtle Island. On Turtle Island, we had traveled thousands of years before the slave ship came. So a lot of us are getting the history that all of us were putting onto ships that we can't even discover. I've never seen a ship. Where are the ships? So we have to be honest with ourselves and know that we are the first people of this land right here. And so that's why what we do is we always honor the people of this land. We cannot be separate and let people tell us that because we are this color or we are that we're not together. We are the descendants of the people on the continent, and we travel. We had boats and planes and stuff thousands of years that people don't even realize. So I just want to implore people to go and study. Study South Africa. Most definitely study the East, study the West. Those studies of young children, learn about Maligana and Songhai. You know, learn about Mansa Musa, who changed the whole economy of the world. You know, we come from greatness that is not just from a slave ship. So we're gonna honor our culture, our history, and each other in honor of this flag. Ashe.
And my name is Minister King Gex. I'm the director of California Prison Focus Case Universal. So many a times when I was in solitary confinement, I was around men who had been there for 30 and 40 years. They was held in solitary confinement for reading literature on George Jackson, for reading literature about being New African, for reading literature, Aztec literature. And they kept them in a hole because these was our principal thinkers. These was our elders who they didn't want out here to teach us about this minicide that we objected to. And when I say minicide, I'm talking about our identity crisis. I'm talking about the food that we eat, the cultural genocide that we go through. I'm talking about the sexism. I'm talking about the police harassment that we go through. George Floyd, that ain't the first time. You know what I mean? And it ain't gonna stop until we, the people, centralize together with our great ideas, with our great resources, pulling our resources together and making a difference out here in the community. So today was about solidarity. So when I'm here and y'all see me out there advocating with Sisters Like Tomorrow, and tell them about what we do.
Along with Mr. King, we work with No Justice Under Capitalism, Ella Baker, Melanated Harmony. I gotta put my plug in for my team. We are out here fighting for the brothers and sisters behind the bars. We want them to stop sterilizing our women against their will. It is not your right to tell them if they can have children or not just because they were convicted of a crime. So we're gonna start there. We gotta protect our sisters, because often the sisters are forgotten about. We want to protect our brothers and speak up for them, especially the ones who are wrongfully convicted, wrongfully sentenced, being held basically in slavery by the government. So we speak out against those atrocities on as many platforms as we can, be it podcasts or in the streets. The fight continues, the marathon continues, and it won't stop until we free them all.
So he wanted to tell you about Rochelle. Go on and tell him about Rochelle. Rochelle with McGee and Mamiya. Tell him about the struggle we're going through with Mamiya. Yeah.
We stand with political prisoners all across the world. We recognize that the political prisoners here are an extension of the slavery that happened. When I was 12 years old, my grandmother dressed me in a dashiki similar to this and took me to Oakland Coliseum to see Nelson Mandela speak. And it was funny to see the Congress celebrate Nelson Mandela as a political prisoner while Mamiya rots in jail. You know, so we have to look at it. Chip Fitzgerald, went to jail as a young man, and even the police that he shot, the security guard that he shot, forgave him and said, don't hold that man no more based upon me. And then you see that he organized hunger strikes to uplift people up in prison. You see the same thing happened with Yogi. You know, when Yogi got out the hole, they sent three white supremacists to go kill him. You know what I mean? But that didn't end the plan to no hostilities, you know what I mean? The plan for no hostilities on the yard. So we have to stand up. We have to remember what happened in the past, look back so we can bring it forward. Sankofa, you know what I mean? So free all political prisoners.
I'm Audrey Kendricorn, and I represent the grieving and breathing mothers. I stand with the revolutionaries, but I take the REV off and I put the LOV in. So I would like to extend you to my extended family to be a revolutionary. So wherever you are, put your hands up and take the oath. We are fighting low vibration. It's not about black, white, Asian, and all of the rest of the nationality. It's not about being fat, about being skinny, being ugly, or being pretty. It's about the low evil vibration that's breaking us apart. We truly are one. We're human and mammals. We are connected to everything. So as we take care of ourselves, it's important to take care of each other. And not just us humans, but the things that cannot hear or talk, or you think they can't hear, like the trees and the insects. They communicate. We don't understand them and they don't understand us. But one thing we have in common is the Creator created us all. I am the black woman. I created a nation.
I'm trying to get everybody together, to love each other, stuff like that, you know, and all that killing stuff. We need to love each other and get together. You know what I'm saying? I am from Arkansas. Well, I've been through it. I've been a black person, and all that stuff, you know, but now everybody needs to come together and love each other and do things to each other. All that killing stuff that each other like that there, it needs to stop. You know, because it don't make no sense. You know, everybody, you know, doing things with him. It's time to live. It's time to have something. It's time to get together and love each other. Love your kids and love your family. You know, don't let the, you know, nobody bring you down or whatever you want in life and dream. Do it. You know, because desire comes. You know, God is here for you. He let the only thing he got to do is get on your knees and pray, and that's God. I don't let nobody take your dreams from you. Don't let nobody take what you want. What you want, you know, get it. Don't let nobody take what you, you know, whatever you want, do it. All you gotta do is ask God, because all this aim is, all this just women is just each other. You know, you look good and you got your hair down and all that just stuff like that, move that, because that's the devil. And then sometimes I had a man love, he's with my husband, my cousin. You know, I don't need to be like that. I need to be around people positive, not the negative things. I need somebody when I'm down and out and I'm crying. You know, somebody gonna help me. That's all I need. Somebody gonna love me. And you know, because that's what I need. And I ask God to make a way for us to have a phone call. I need to help. I need to talk. Sometimes you can save somebody's life. You know, that's all I'm saying. Thank you, Jesus.
And nothing gangster about that. Gangster is when you're able to stand up against the oppressor. Fight a righteous war. Fight a righteous struggle in the service of your people. Black August is the foundation that facilitates that process. So all the programs in Black August designed to transform that slave mentality. But one thing we try to tell people, Black August is not just during the month of August. What we're doing in Black August is plant the seed. Now, throughout the other months of the year, we're cultivating that seed. So if we start a program during the month of Black August, that program continues to move forward during the other months. So the next Black August, what we do, we assess the strength and weakness of that program. with the success and failure and make the necessary adjustment. So if you exercise throughout the year, if you fasten during...
Okay, my name is Tracy Bell Borden, and I'm a member of the Ella Baker Center for Human Rights. I'm also an activist that works with prison reform. I am a mother whose child was formerly incarcerated. Over $37 of dishwashing detergent being stolen by another person. And my daughter was, she was stolen from by the Oakland Police Department. It took me, I had to pay a $10,000 bail for a $37 incident that she didn't do anything. And it took about $20,000 just to for all the other fees, for court and everything. So I'm just one that I think that we need to advocate as parents for our children. I tell parents all the time, because the system is wicked and little things like that can ruin your child's life. And I'm just one that believes that we need to support each other, and we need to support our children when they get into that system. Because even after spending $30,000 for my daughter, she still can't get a job. She still, but I had to keep her out of the system. So I'm a mother who believes that I wasn't gonna leave her in a system that I was not willing to be in. So I just tell people to protect your children. And if you get a chance, check out the Ella Baker Center for Human Rights.
You, as a young African man, how do you see us promoting peace out here in the streets?
As young men, it's very necessary and important to promote peace, because we oftentimes fall into wrong lanes and go into other unnecessary and bad stuff. So us coming together and promoting peace is very good, I guess. Yeah.
You guys promoting peace is better for us, because you're kind of paving our, like, a path for us, so we can have a better future and not get killed like the people out in the streets by cops and our own. So I think it's very necessary for us to, for you guys to promote peace, and like for us to help you guys.
Hey y'all, this is a way to stop killing each other, because we not black on black crime is on teenagers, and we need to stop it, because we are not the enemies, and we need to come as together as a community and educate ourselves about the law and promote peace. And this is what we're doing right now, and just no more gang violence. And this is another way to promote our future and keep our lives safe.
It's necessary for us to do the to do our protest and make sure we don't get killed, because we're not the people that are doing the wrong stuff. We're getting committed for things that we didn't do, and then we go to jail, and then some bad things happen to us.
In my celebration for Black August, I have a poem. Kind of something that needs to happen between, you know, really between those, you know, between white and black people, because, you know, especially, you know, well, with racist white black, racist white people specifically, it's, and I call the poem a conversation. We need to talk about this hatred you have in your heart. We know it exists, but where did it start? During the slave trade, we were treated as property. Ever since then, we've denied our humanity. Not seeing us as human makes us easier to hate. Spreading rumors and lies so we will be easily despised, and the hatred of us easier to relate. The truth of us being human shouldn't be up for debate. Another reason for this hateful treason is you didn't want us to be free. You still believe the rumors and lies made up about our lack of humanity. Make America Great Again translates to going back to times of slavery. But that's just a whitewashed fantasy. It would be great for you, but hell on earth, me. Because you would be able to rob, rape, and kill without, with absolute impunity. just like the police do now with qualified immunity. But all of you want to be officers because you still see yourselves as overseers. But the best way to describe you is a racist, bigoted, hate monger. Aren't you tired of the rest of the world looking at you strange? Don't you think it's time for this hateful mindset to change? I'm hoping this conversation can teach you a lesson so that you realize that the people you once enslaved and victimized can no longer accept your oppression.
I love what the new Africans are doing. They are speaking life to the living, and I want to be a part of it. I'm about saving our youth, saving our souls, and doing what's right. UNITY, when Queen Latifah and the Legendary Legends have started, we need to come together and unite, because united we stand, divided we fall, y'all. We got to stand tall through it all, you know, and conquer and destroy all of the elements against us and the spiritual warfare all around us. So what we need to do is not fear nothing but the Lord and keep on pushing and keep it together. Weave it together, my brothers, my sisters, my kings and my queens. I'm crying out. This is a war cry, battle cry. So I'm just letting you guys know. This is peachy cream, y'all. I just want to let you know everything's going to be peachy cream if y'all let it be. Let it be peaceful. Let it be together, that unity. Let it stand. United we stand, divided we fall. But we got to stand tall through it all. God bless y'all. Peace and blessings.
We came out here today on 4/17/2021 to film a piece called New Africans. You know, earlier I was describing how I was subjected to a whole lot of campaign harassment because of my ideology, my opinion, my worldview. There's a lot of men and women still held captive because of the 13th Amendment. So I want to talk about Chip Fitzgerald, who went in when he was younger, and he died as an elder who was on the cane. He died because of the draconian system, because CDC small R, California Department of Corrections, fell and refused to liberate this elder. So now we out here with boots on the ground trying to free them all. So what's the call? Free them all. Strategic relief. Thank you.